On a guess, lend me your ears. Long as our Fevremonde suffered, without a true monarch to guide her and her people. Decades have passed since last His Majesty Erland sat atop the Draken throne. Long have we endured, yet it has not been for naught. At last, the bell has tolled on the age of the Consul. At last, we may celebrate the coming of our rightful ruler. The return of the Sovereign.
My word, such an inspiring visage.
Your Majesty shall have my eternal fealty.
Your Majesty, oh how long I have awaited this moment.
Behold, before you sits the rightful inheritor of the Draken throne, chosen by the dragon as its enemy. Behold and rejoice! Fortune has delivered us our savior at last!
At last!
Praise be, for only the Sovereign's guidance can lead us true. All hail the Sovereign!
All hail!
Let all present pledge your allegiance to the Sovereign. Let us be united in the hope that our liege's reign will ne'er end. Long live the Sovereign of Vermont!
Long live the Sovereign!
Who is it? Thou who wouldst slay the dragon. If thou seekest to behold this world in its true aspect, abandon thy reason. Cast aside thine heart and thy life both. I ask thee to demonstrate thy will, for naught but thine ambition can alter the course of the rivers of fate.
Now, which one of you was it? No need to be shy. I've just got to take down a record of your name and face. Come on, step forward. Are you the one? Aha! I thought I recognized you. I ill like that look in your eyes. 'Tis queerly brazen for a pawn. Most of your kind have eyes blank as a cadaver's. Mayhap 'tis only natural, seeing as how you rise from the dead. There's aught different about you, though. Could it be that you fear death just as we mortals do? Worry not, vessel. 3 days here, and you'll be longing for death's sweet embrace. Come along, you feckless dullards!
Learn your place, pawn.
What do you want?
Not sure how much longer I can hold out.
I want to polish up my gear for the morrow.
I suppose I'd best be heading home.
Get a move on!
Do your injuries pain you? Pray, do not overexert yourself. This is no place for one of your ilk. 'Tis harsh beyond measure. Even we pawns are pushed to the brink. You ought not anger the overseer. Let us proceed to the site.
I ought to turn in for the night.
My legs are stiff as boards after training.
Bring myself to do much.
Time for you to get to work.
You are prepared to work. Then you ought begin by carrying stones out from the station in the back and bringing them here.
The vicinity is quite cluttered. Pray leap.
A job well done. Now the next step is to... What is this commotion? Perhaps we ought to investigate. Your phone till the arrows are welcome. alike can make effective weapons ever combatant. When delivering targeted strikes, I would recommend pinning to it.
No one could survive a fall from this height. Not even a pawn. Don't just stand there! Shoot it down!
Thank you.
Pray, keep your distance, Arisen. Worry not for me. The brine may swallow me whole, but I will not perish. There is a stone not far from here, known as a rift stone. Pray, seek it out. If you're truly the Arisen, then our paths will surely cross again.
Oi! Are you all right? What happened here? A griffin appears one moment and falls the next. And now you stand before me. Was it you then? The one who was riding on its back? It is a wonder you survived. Accompany me to the stronghold. We'll treat your wounds and hear your story. Still, I can hardly believe it. A griffin of all things here. Add to that the recent dragon sighting. It is said that the arrival of the Sovereign portends an age of peace, yet only trouble has followed. What does it all mean? I had thought being in the Border Watch would make for easy work. The wind's beginning to blow in a fell direction. Where exactly is this jail you say you escaped from? I've never heard of such a place. There's certainly naught like that here in Vermont. Could it be you were held in the neighboring country of Batal? Nay, that's unlikely. We've been estranged from Batal ever since the war. It is difficult to imagine any citizen of Vermont being sent there. Five! Goblins! Let's take up your weapons, sir. You'll be needing it. Where are you going? I'll not force you to listen to me, but I at least like the work. There are often items to be scavenged from the bodies of monsters and their ilk. If you're not squeamish about picking at their bones, that is. Have you beheld the dragon as yet? I've not, and I count that a blessing. All I know for sure is that 'tis a beast e'er more fearsome than a griffin. One need only be in the miserable state of the village of Melbourne. We can but hope the Sultan will rid us of the airlock. That's the Sovereign's duty, isn't it? When the dragon rears its ugly head, the Sovereign appears among the people and steps forth to challenge it. I dare say Vermin owes much of its prosperity to the Sovereigns who have served it over time. Though, personally...
Welcome, Arisen. We pawns have long awaited your arrival.
What is this? Pawns? They bend the knee to you so readily, but then... No. Surely you cannot be the Arisen.
You seek the Rift Stone, do you not? We can take you to it. Pray. Come this way. Before you stands a rift stone. Tis a gate by which we of the Pawn Legion may cross o'er into this world. Pray, summon your pawn. Simply paint with your mind's eye the loyal attendant whom you would have serve you.
We pawns are travelers of not only this world, but myriad others with which we can connect. As your loyal pawn, my duty is to accompany you and use what I learn in these other realms to aid you on your journey. I shall be with you every step of the way, and I hope to put my knowledge and experiences to good use on your behalf.
Well, I'll be. A pawn summoning before my very eyes. You truly are the Arisen, then. Strange. I thought the Arisen was in the capital. Surely there's only meant to be one Arisen. Fie. This is all beyond my ken. The Watchhead would know what to do, I'm sure. Though, as luck would have it, he's away. I suppose we'll save any further questions till the Watchhead returns. You're free to do as you like afore then. What? You've no memories, you say? Mayhap you could make for Melv, then. 'Twas set upon by the dragon not long ago. The Arisen is said to bear some deep connection to the dragon. Should you be Arisen, mayhap you'll recall aught of import there.
Hail, Arisen. Pray, ask aught you wish to know. I shall answer, if 'tis within my power to do so. Very well. May fortune speed you on your way, Arisen.
Tis a ladder.
Hoy there. You seem well tired. Tell you what, you can stay here tonight free of charge. I'll expect coin from tomorrow, mind. My pa always used to say, there's naught a good night's sleep can't fix. Not much else I can offer, I'm afraid, but you'll find all sorts at a finer inn. Aye, being armed is better than being defenseless, even if you're untrained. Still, 'tis worth devoting yourself to a vocation if you can. Opens up new doors, it does. You should stop by the inn in Melv if you get the chance. No hard feelings if you prefer it. They've much more to offer.
There are worse things than turning in early, I must say. Look, Master, a treasure chest. We shall have to find a way to reach it.
If you're playing Arisen in search of preferable treat.
I've beds to spare if you're looking for lodgings. And if you'd like to change your vocation, come see me anytime. Do come again.
Master, if ever your pack grows cumbersome, know that I would be glad to purchase any of your unwanted items. Twill be an honor to serve by your...
Fancy a gander? I fight.
Goods for sale. Much obliged.
Heyo, you a soldier? It would be a surprise to see you arrive in one piece, if not. Hordes of monsters have been plaguing this area of late, you see. We've had to start sending out new recruits to cull them.
Is that so? Who went yonder?
Lachlan. But I dare say he'll fare all right.
Aye, I expect he will.
Accardo. To be honest, sir, I'm a little worried.
What? Weren't harpies reported in that area? I can't handle those beasts on his own.
This is the first I'm hearing of it. Fie! I want to go to his aid, but we can't just abandon our posts. Say, you seem stout of heart. Would you be willing to go in our stead? Tisn't far, only a short ways out from the main gate. You've my thanks. And Accardo's as well, I'm sure.
We must fly to the aid of those in need. Sir, Cardo is in need of our aid. I believe... I can guide you to the person in question. One might confidently call that a resounding victory.
Well, I'm sure there's still room for improvement. Ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
Shall-
Yeah, Master! Pardon!
He's weak to fire!
You have my thanks. I do not believe for a moment I could have slain those creatures without your help. I've only just enlisted, and when I thought this could be the end of me, I was paralyzed. You saved me this time, but I won't always be so fortunate. I'll have to train harder, till I've the confidence to face such beasts on my own. Well, I'd best be heading back, but I'll be sure to let my superiors know of your good deed. I hope we meet again someday.
I have a knack for gathering items, and am ever on the hunt for new finds. I'll gladly try out any useful mechanisms I espy.
Pray, follow me. Putting that aside, now that I think on it, we've arrived, just as planned.
Hail, friend! Many thanks for aiding Accardo. 'Twas a relief to see him return, and none the worse for wear.
Aye, that it was. The poor sod might not have made it back alive had you not intervened.
'Twas a bit too early for him to be seen actual combat. That much was made well clear. We'll be extending his training period. The instructors here are well known for whipping recruits into shape with their grueling regimes.
Speaking of training regimes, I must admit I've half a mind to ask you to join us. We could use someone with your experience.
Fancy a gander? Fine, just for sale.
I'll not stick
visit to Melv might jog your memory, Master. It seems the village yet reels from the dragon's assault. Follow me, Master. I shall guide you to the location.
Well now, isn't this lucky? Someone who knows the way. You run so fast! You can hardly keep you in my sights, Arisen!
Let us endeavor to keep up! So we are left.
Good feeling about this one. There's a worthy prize. If only t'weren't so far away. Smashing success.
Let us try for the same result with our next attack. Ought we not add an archer to our ranks?
Indeed. I admire the deft skill with which they hit their marks.
Here we go again.
Use no forearm.
I am well aware.
Chest appears to be beyond our reach.
Surely we can make our way over to it somehow. Over here, if you please.
Prod me if you must, Master, but I've nothing more to say.
As a matter of fact... Curious thing. One of my former masters chose to hire only women. I wonder why. Not like a feast to get you ready for bed.
I quite agree. Best we recuperate our strength before we set off again.
Now we've the vim to tackle the day ahead.
Off we go then. There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
No harm in picking a few. As your pack becomes heavier, so too does your step. Perchance, you ought to let a few things go. You watch where you're going. You'll hurt yourself one of these days.
Oh, don't worry me. These things happen. Valuable, this.
A fitting reward for a rigorous search. Come, I'll lead the way. Have you a different destination in mind, Master? Very well. I shall follow your lead instead.
Perhaps the Arisoners recalled some more pressing business. Fret not. I'm sure we'll come back to this eventually.
So, this is Melv. The scars left by the dragon's assault are plain to see. Mayhap a walk through the streets would help jog your memory. When the Arisen appears, so too does the dragon. 'Tis an immutable truth of this world.
That's just what I was thinking.
Well met. Pleasure doing business with you.
It takes two to make a sale, and this cellar had nothing to tempt us with. Our funds are better spent elsewhere.
Gold is a resource best spent judiciously.
That is most unfortunate, but it doth not release thee from thy fate.
Thank you. Can you hear me, sir? Sir, stay with me. Goodness. How are you feeling? This is the second time I've watched over you like this, isn't it? You do not remember? Then have you forgotten that you protected me from the dragon's flames? You withstood the fire in my stead and were well and truly charred. 'Twas terrible. I had thought your life forfeit. I could not hear the beating of your heart. You hung on and, by some miracle, survived. Arisen. I'm afraid I don't understand your meaning. Does it have aught to do with why you were taken to the castle? They said 'twas so that your wounds could be treated, though I fear you have no memory of this either. Has he come for you? We are to part so soon, then. Mayhap you will visit me again someday. Till then, take care. Arisen.
Ah, excellent. You must be the one. You match my soldier's description. I'm glad I found you. The ruler of Vermund, currently convalescing in the capital, became arisen here in this very village. If you claim the same, then word must be borne to the capital. I dispatched a missive before coming here, though I doubt the matter can be settled without your presence. Would you be willing to accompany me to the capital? If you truly are arisen, you will be received with open arms. Oh, but forgive me. I scattered my soldiers in a bid to find you. I would not depart without them. We shall have to wait till they are reassembled. Come to think of it, Sir Leonard was asking after you as well. Mayhap now would be a good time to speak with him. Last I saw, he was having a drink at the inn.
Chest appears to be beyond our reach.
Surely we can make our way over to it somehow.
Over here, if you please.
Prod me if you must, Master, but I've nothing more to say.
As a matter of fact... Curious thing. One of my former masters chose to hire only women. I wonder why. Not like a feast to get you ready for bed.
I quite agree. Best we recuperate our strength before we set off again.
Now we've the vim to tackle the day ahead.
Off we go then. There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
No harm in picking a few. As your pack becomes heavier, so too does your step. Perchance, you ought to let a few things go. Do watch where you're going. You'll hurt yourself one of these days.
Oh, don't mind me. These things happen. Valuable, this.
A fitting reward for a rigorous search. Come, I'll lead the way. Have you a different destination in mind, Master? Very well. I shall follow your lead instead.
Perhaps the Arisoners recalled some more pressing business. Fret not. I'm sure we'll come back to this eventually.
This is Melv. The scars left by the dragon's assault are plain to see. Mayhap a walk through the streets would help jog your memory. When the Arisen appears, so too does the dragon. 'Tis an immutable truth of this world.
That's just what I was thinking.
Well met. Pleasure doing business with you.
It takes two to make a sale, and this cellar had nothing to tempt us with. Our funds are better spent elsewhere.
Gold is a resource best spent judiciously.
Most unfortunate, but it doth not release thee from thy fate.
Can you hear me, sir? Sir, stay with me. Thank goodness. How are you feeling? This is the second time I've watched over you like this, isn't it? You do not remember? Then have you forgotten that you protected me from the dragon's flames? You withstood the fire in my stead and were well and truly charred. 'Twas terrible. I had thought your life forfeit. I could not hear the beating of your heart. You hung on, and by some miracle, survived. Arisen. I'm afraid I don't understand your meaning. Does it have aught to do with why you were taken to the castle? They said 'twas so that your wounds could be treated, though I fear you have no memory of this either. Has he come for you? We are to part so soon, then. Mayhap you will visit me again someday. Till then, take care. Arisen.
Ah, excellent. You must be the one. You match my soldier's description. I'm glad I found you. The ruler of Vermont, currently convalescing in the capital, became arisen here in this very village. If you claim the same, then word must be borne to the capital. I dispatched a missive before coming here, though I doubt the matter can be settled without your presence. Would you be willing to accompany me to the capital? If you truly are arisen, you will be received with open arms. Oh, but forgive me. I scattered my soldiers in a bid to find you. I would not depart without them. We shall have to wait till they are reassembled. Come to think of it, Sir Lennet was asking after you as well. Mayhap now would be a good time to speak with him. Last I saw, he was having a drink at the inn.
Who might have the answers we need? Shall we ask around?
Say, do you think this one's really arisen?
Oh, have you some business with the apothecary, sir? Dreadful sorry if I was in your way.
Oh, no, I'm not lost or naught, sir. You needn't worry yourself on my account. I'm an apothecary in training, you see. My family runs a little shop in Vernworth. So when I heard tell of a medicine only to be found in this village, I thought I'd come and fetch some for us. Made the journey all by myself as well, if you can believe it.
But, well, as luck would have it, I've not enough gold for the medicine. It will be a shame to return empty-handed after coming all this way. But what more can I do? What? You do that? Suppose there's no harm in that. If you're really sure... Oh, sir, I'd be most grateful. Seems my luck's not as rotten as I'd thought. I'll wait right here for your return.
We could make the fruit roborant ourselves, or simply purchase some at Rune. Apothecary here in Melv.
Ah, now I understand.
Ah, well met. Here for some fruit roborant, are we?
Always a pleasure.
We ought to bring this to the one expecting it.
Hello again, sir. Say, have you brought some fruit rubber in? Oh, so this is what it looks like. Brilliant. Many thanks, sir.
I haven't much to offer in return, but I'll be sure to tell Grandfather.
One could not have hoped for a gladder outcome.
Well met, sir.
How might I be of service? Always a pleasure.
Well met. You're the one who saved Ulrika's life, aren't you? She told me all about it. It was a very brave thing you did. I'm in your debt. Ulrika's as good as my daughter. Here, consider this a small token of my gratitude. Now, tell me. Are you registered with a guild? Perhaps you already know this, but registering with a guild will grant you access to specialized training, which comes in very useful when pursuing a vocation. Well now, that won't do. You need only speak with the innkeeper to register. Go on, it'll only take a moment. If there is aught you wish to know of vocations, mayhap I can advise you. 'Tis a vocation for those who seek to master the dagger. Such blades lack heft, though this grants them the advantage of speed. Thieves favor light armor, which leaves them more vulnerable to attack. Their talents depend upon their finesse and ability to compensate for the length of their blade through sheer agility. Very well. There is no wrong. But I shan't take up any more of your time. Pray.
Never for a moment did I doubt you'd gross.
Here at the inn, I get so few customers, you see, that I can manage both roles myself. But enough about me. Did you need something?
Thank you.
Always a pleasure.
There's something.
So this is where you've been. Come with me to the village entrance. The Watchhead's waiting for you.
Shall we seek some answers?
Well met, sir. Might I be of service?
Do come again.
You really ought to have returned by now. Mayhap 'tis time I went looking for you.
Ah, you've returned. Good timing, too. I have questions for you. First and foremost, will you accompany my thanks? Are you ready to depart, or do you need some time to prepare? Good. Then let us be on our way.
It's a glad thing we rested when we did.
Try not to get hit. You're still wet. Go for that.
You must cleanse yourself with that oil for the taste.
Over so soon? Why, we seem to have come through unscathed.
Overconfidence is an enemy in and of itself. Let us instead strive to better ourselves with every... Well done, Master.
The ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
The Arisen is the lawful ruler of Vermund. So it has always been. To claim the title is to claim the throne. Yet not all claims are true. Our kingdom sees many pretenders, and they are not dealt with lightly. There's token of one. Regardless, do well not to invite mistrust.
That looks breakable. I doubt our attacks will reach it from this distance.
Would that I had some means of attacking from afar, but alas, I do not. Guard all you want. It won't make a difference when I grapple, you see?
say we toss a combustible at it and set it alight.
Look there. I espy another statue.
Let us make our way over to it while it is in our sights. What a view. I'd not say no to a short repose hereabouts.
We are alone here, methinks. Perhaps we might stop a moment and find our bearings.
That's just what I was thinking.
You're like to grow overburdened if you keep picking up every little trinket you find.
I'll harvest what I can, should it please you.
I know precisely when a curative is needed, Master. Delighted to meet you.
Hold here a moment. I shall bid them open the gate.
Who's that you've brought with you, Watchhead, sir?
An arisen, by all appearances.
An arisen? Another pretender, you mean? I see the Sovereign's ascension has done little to stop such charlatans from plying their trade.
Tis uncertain. This one commands the loyalty of the pawns.
What? Impossible. You know as well as I do that there can be but one arisen, and he's up in the palace.
I'm well aware of how preposterous the idea is, thank you. However, as I do not believe it my place to rule on such a matter, I would make my report to the capital. If the claim is false, we will be rewarded handsomely for our trouble. If the claim is true, however, who can say? All's been arranged. Come, let us pass through the gate.
Once.
could yon chest be hiding? I must know.
Let us hope you're curious.
Naught like a curative to fill one with vim.
An ox cart was meant to meet us, yet tis nowhere in sight. Aught may have befallen it. Best we press on.
This is generally used as a material.
Different combinations of materials result in different creations.
I'll carefully conserve my strength and endeavor to survive every battle. Over many fierce battles was our bond for.
Do forgive me, Master, but I've not learned.
I pray my efforts aid your cause. Are you fit to travel?
For travel in our master's presence is to be graced with a compassion most wholesome.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
We could pick some now and use them when the need arises. It's about time we pressed on, wouldn't you say, Master?
Is everyone all right? More marks of the dragon's fury. Its rampage must have weakened the earth here.
Ooh, I can't wait to find out what's inside.
I would have preferred not to have to fight so soon. But at least I know I am up to the challenge.
Try not to get hit, lest all that vim go to waste.
Just think what we could achieve if we honed our talents further.
Lucky us. That's worth taking. And here I was hoping for some great treasure. Oh, now I feel a fool.
We'll find you, Brit, I'm sure.
Thank you.
I dare say the cart shan't be traversing this. Onward! It might await us on the road ahead.
To be called to your side, Arisen. My curative magics are at your disposal. Wait right there.
Eyes up! Carpets are upon us!
We'll want to use fire against this one. Ourselves a pat on the back.
Well, I'm sure there's still room for improvement.
That ladder looks promising, but we'll have to drop it down from above. I'll just pick this up.
Oof. My pack's grown rather heavy.
Well, let us make haste for the nearest town.
I'd wager there's ought to be found here.
Let us ponder how best to proceed.
Of the century, I dare say. I wonder whether my master from beyond the rift managed to find that. Somehow, I doubt it.
Ah. You can count on me to fly to your aid in your hour of need, master. Knowing when to use curatives is my specialty.
Ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
I say we collect as much as we can carry.
What's this? We're trapped!
Hi! A Cyclops! To think we'd encounter one here, of all places!
A Cyclops? Oh, pray, be on your guard!
Out!
have my gratitude, sir. It would seem I misjudged you. I had taken you for another false arisen. Goodness knows we see a lot of them. Yet the valley you showed in coming to our aid has dispelled such thoughts. Here, take this. Give it to one of the sentinels stationed at the gates to the capital, and you'll be granted an audience with Captain Brandt. You're free to make your own way to the capital now. I see no need to keep you under constant watch, and I'm sure you'll breathe a little easier as well, aye? Of course, if you'd rather continue to accompany us, you are still welcome to join us on the Oxcart. 'Tis your decision.
No debilitation of curative cult men.
Now, this is a good find.
Perhaps fortune has deigned to aid us at last.
Pray slow your feet! You run too fast for the likes of me!
No time to catch your breath! Try to keep up! Unless my eyes deceive me, there's something down. There.
Should've